Hello everyone, my name is Josef Ibarra and I'm an engineer on the Identity Customer Experience team at Microsoft. Today, I'm going to explain how to configure selective password hash synchronization for Azure AD Connect. Let's start.
First, I will provide an explanation of password hash synchronization, which is one of the assigned methods used to accomplish a hybrid identity environment. When password hash synchronization is enabled, Azure AD Connect synchronizes a hash of the hash of a user's password from on-premises Active Directory to Azure Active Directory. By default, password hash synchronization will occur for all the users who are synced to cloud and for whom password hash synchronization has been enabled. Now, let's talk about selective password hash synchronization, which is a rule-based solution to allow you to exclude users from synchronizing the password hash to cloud. Some important things to have in consideration before enabling selective password hash synchronization. Selective password hash synchronization directly influences password writeback. Only the users that are in the scope of password hash synchronization can reset their password using password writeback. After the configuration is done, it will require a full synchronization to apply the changes. The scope of the rule is based on the attribute admin description. Also, we will need to understand which is larger, the number of users to exclude or the number of users to include. This will help us to reduce the configuration administrative effort. In this video, we will cover both the scenarios. I'm going to start showing how to configure the rules when excluded users are less than included users. Before starting, we will need to disable the synchronization scheduler. We don't want the synchronization to be triggered before completing the rules configuration. Open PowerShell and run this command to disable the scheduler. Set AD Sync Scheduler Sync Cycle Enabled False. We can check the status of the scheduler with Get AD Sync Scheduler. Once we are sure that the scheduler is disabled, we can proceed to open the Synchronization Rules Editor. Here, we're going to create and edit a copy of the rule Inform AD User Account Enabled. We're going to unselect the option Enable Password Hash Sync. Put the precedence value to a number lower than 100. Then, check that the disabled box is not marked. Let's name the rule InformAD User Account Enabled Filter Users from PHS. Let's click on a scope and filter. Click on Add Class. Then, select Admin Description equals PHS Filtered. We're using the PHS filtered value because in this scenario, the excluded users is smaller than the included users. Now we can save the rule, click OK in the warning dialog box. That rule will filter the users from password hash synchronization. Now we need another rule to include users. Let's create and edit another copy of the rule in from AD user account enabled. We're going to enable the option Enable Password Hash Synchronization. Put the precedence value to a number lower than the previously created rule. Check that the disabled box is not marked. Let's name the rule InformAD User Account Enable Users Included for PHS. Let's click on the scope and filter. Click on Add Class. Then select admin description not equals PHS filtered. Now we can save the rule, click OK in the warning dialog box. Now that we have configured both rules, let's do a test with two users. Let's look for the user that we want to filter in Active Directory. Go to the Attribute Editor, look for the Attribute Admin Description. Then, add the value PHS Filtered. This will make the scope for the password hash synchronization filter rule created previously. For the other user, we will need to add a value that is not equals to PHS Filtered or just leave the attribute null. Back in the Azure AD Connect server, let's enable the synchronization scheduler using PowerShell. Let's run set a async scheduler sync cycle enable true. Check the status using get async scheduler. Now, let's trigger a synchronization cycle using start async sync cycle. This will automatically run the full synchronization step to apply the previously created rules. To confirm that the hash is not being synchronized to cloud, we can check in the synchronization service manager. In the sync step, click on projections for new added users, or click on connectors with flow updates for existing users. Then, click on the user that has been filtered. When the new window prompts up, click on log. We should not see any log. Meanwhile, in the included users, we should get a success. Now, let's configure the rules when the excluded users are more than the included users. Before starting, we will need to disable the synchronization scheduler. We don't want the synchronization to be triggered before completing the rules configuration. Open PowerShell and run this command to disable the scheduler. Set async scheduler sync cycle enabled false. We can check the status of the scheduler with get async scheduler. Once we are sure that the scheduler is disabled, we can proceed to open the synchronization rules editor. Here, we're going to create and edit a copy of the rule informAD user account enabled. We're going to unselect the option enable password hash sync. Put the precedence value to a number lower than 100. Then, check that the disabled box is not marked. Let's name the rule informAD user account enabled filter users from PHS. Let's click on a scoping filter. Click on Add Clause. Select Admin Description. Not equals PHS include. Now we can save the rule. Click OK in the warning dialog box. That rule will filter the users from password hash synchronization. Now we need another rule to include users. Let's create and edit another copy of the rule informAD user account enable. We're going to enable the option enable password hash synchronization. Put the precedence value to a number lower than the previously created rule. Check that the disabled box is not marked. Let's name the rule informAD user account enable users included for PHS. Let's click on a scoping filter. Click on Add Clause. Select Admin Description. Equals PHS include. Now we can save the rule. Click OK in the warning dialog box. Now that we have configured both rules, let's do a test with two users. Let's look for the user that we want to include in Active Directory. Go to Attribute Editor. In the Attribute Admin Description, we will add the value PHS include. This will meet the scope for the rule that has password hash synchronization enabled. For the other user, we will need to add a value that is not equals to PHS include or just leave the attribute null. Back in the Azure AD Connect server, let's enable the synchronization scheduler using PowerShell. Let's run set async scheduler sync cycle enable it true. Check the status using get async scheduler. Now, let's trigger a synchronization cycle using start async sync cycle. This will automatically run the full synchronization step to apply the previously created rules. To confirm that the hash is not being synchronized to cloud, we can check in the Synchronization Service Manager. In the sync step, click on Projections for new added users, or click on Connector with Flow Updates for existing users. Click on the user that is being excluded. When the new window prompts up, click on Log. We should not see any log. Meanwhile, in the included users, we should get a success.
This is how we configure selective password hash synchronization for Azure AD Connect. Hopefully, you will find this video helpful on what to do for excluding users from password hash synchronization. For more information, please refer to our public documentation on docs.microsoft.com. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.